Oh my God, my mic's been unplugged the whole time. I've been talking this whole time. Gave a full spiel. I've been even watching my own stream, but I just thought I had the volume turned down so it didn't echo. Turns out I didn't have my mic plugged in at all. So if you're still here and you're still watching, thank you. I appreciate it. Welcome. I hope it wasn't a waste of time. I hope the stream was of all right quality for you. We're going over to my other base that we didn't get to see tonight on Zeus stream, which is my cabin build. I called it my paraffinium plateau plantation, because it's up on top of a big old plateau. And I have paraffinium out there. Little paraffinium farm. And the plantation part was, I was going to build a bunch of crops and animal things out here. There's some animal feeders and milkers over there by the paraffinium refiner farm thing. I love these big Saturn rings up over the build here. Big old planet in the background. But this is the paraffinium cabin. Been a roofer for a lot of years and always hated the steep roofs. I've had to roof a lot of cabins in Idaho, and they don't look quite as intricate as these, but pretty much built. I wanted to combine cuboid rooms with the regular base parts. And so I did that. I wanted a cool looking A-frame cabin build. I think I accomplished that. It's up on this huge plateau here though. Pretty cool planet. My power supply is down there somewhere. I think it's that little glowy thing over there. Let's go back inside. Nice little barbecue out on the front porch. Automatic doors. This tree just keeps wanting to grow back in my poker room over here, but got a nice little poker table. Tree's not included usually. Give us a little save. Give us a little heat. It's not a cold planet, but you know, role play it. This is my little kitchen, my fridge, my beers in front of the cooler, some storage, the nuker, little mini table. No glitching. You can do that on PS4 just by shrinking the table down. Makes a nice little like dessert tray or something. Two-story bottom floor, actually three-story cuboid. Let's go upstairs. three floors, and we get a weapon room, lounge area, living room, couple little guest beds there, another little balcony here. Balcony over here. Yeah, it's actually a built balcony. And then another balcony over here on this side. Nice views. And then the bedroom up here. A little snack counter. A little lounge. The wardrobe, some recliners, some lockers, some robotic arms to get my ass out of bed in the morning. And then, plenty of room for the harem to sleep with you. A couple more lockers, a little heater, another little balcony overlooking the ship. Both sides, but this one's got stairs, so it doesn't really make sense to have that there, but symmetry. And that's the paraphernalia cabin. My little maid cook over here in the corner. Not too much going on in here. A little bit of this and that. Mostly just cuboid on the inside here. I didn't worry about really getting too much wood or rustic look inside the cabin. Wanted it more of a space futuristic kind of look to it. And then have it real woodsy and unique on the outside. Wish these trees would go away though. Wrap around porch. All the way around it. Both sides come down the side, and the main front porch here is detached. I was gonna do a little bit of a garage underneath the landing pad here. And the floors kept sinking into the ground and disappearing and stuff, so I just left it a bunch of open garage doors that you can't fit your Exocraft in anyways, unless they're two-story. Just kind of a pointless room under there. Milking a bunch of animals and stuff on this planet. Pinididius. Man, you got a big butt. Hey. And there's some of those deer that are all lit up. What do you call those? Jingle deer? What's that guy over there? He's got something weird on his back. What? Oh, I scanned a bush. I was like, that does not look like that creature. What is that? Is that a big tree? Oh, that is a big tree. It was already here. All these trees were already here. And then, yeah, that's the. Go up into camera mode. Pretty simple build up here. Just stacked some mineral extractors on top of each other, and then stacked some triangles on top of those. I think there's three triangles and a ball. Have your ball on top. And then you simply just wire glitch to the sides of the pyramids. You get this nice funky effect. The only reason it's not running right now is because it's full. Let's see how much it holds. I don't remember. I don't think I need any paraffinium. Grab a little bit, just a little run. Thumping right along. This cabin is one of my least viewed videos that I have up. But I like it. I think it looks pretty cool. Spent way too much time on steep 12 pitch inclines. Standing like this, roofing along. 16 years doing siding and roofing and certified in concrete. Did a bunch of framing. Never wanted to do concrete again after I certified in it. Went to siding, did some trim work. Yeah, I like it. Never seen another No Man's Sky cabin that looks like this. I didn't really model it off of anything. Just kind of wireframed it with wires, like I said, and then started cutting up the A-frames. But here's a little tip, a little builder-to-builder tip right here. If you glitch, just wire glitch a roof panel, a slanted roof panel like this, to a cuboid room, like right in the middle of the cuboid, and you wire glitch it to that, it'll increase the pitch of that roof panel by double, because instead of putting it on the ground and having a pitch, you're putting it on a wall and increasing the pitch times two. So that's how I got most of my angles, was just by glitching to a cuboid room with a wall or a slanted roof panel. If you want, I'll demonstrate it real quick. Maybe. Okay. Cuboid room, we'll go glass. Just because this is made out of glass mostly. And then we'll go slanted roof panel. I think stairs work too, but just get it green stated. And see what pitch it is right now. It's like a six pitch. But if you just green state it and then glitch it to the side of this cuboid room, then it makes it a lot steeper. And you can do a lot of crazy things with just glitching your own pitch to things. Of course, this isn't going to work, but red stated. But you get the idea. That's pretty much how I made this whole A-frame cabin. Oh, bushes. Cuboids on the inside, wood on the outside. What do you think? Think I did a good job? Like to come visit, hang out, have some brats and some beers on the back porch here, overlooking the valley. We're up on one of those kind of forest underneath this big old plateau. And I was thinking about doing like a teleporter elevator or something down here to this forest. Superheated rainstorm. Why are all my planets have superheated rainstorms on them? Seems like that's the normal for lush planets, paradise planets. Came down here once and climbed up this rock. This is pretty much where the closest spot of the floating island starts, and I dug pretty much straight up with my terrain manipulator. Made myself a little chute down here. Ooh, this rainstorm's gnarly. And this big old massive thing above me is not giving me any protection. Doesn't seem right. But yeah, when it's not all stormy and nasty out, pretty cool forest down here. Do you have any other planets in this, or bases in this system? This place is nice. So I do have another base in this system. It's nowhere that I've built on before. I just plopped a base computer down. Looks like it's out here on this little viridescent planet. And that's my paraffinium farm. Okay. Never mind. What other bases do we have close by? Acid Mountain, Mega Base, oh, the first racetrack. We could go to the racetrack. Work on that for a minute. I want somebody come race me. I think it was Boss and Zombie came and raced one night, but you can only have two racers in a race at a time. And we're trying to race three of us. There's the jingle deer. Jingle deer, jingle deer, jingle deer hop. Get me a beer. Okay. Let's get out of this storm. Go check out the racetrack. Not too many people have seen the racetrack. It's on a trippy, weird planet with big rings and big diplos. It's another planet where I did a lot of harvesting of animals to get tall eggs and proto cream. Couple other rare items. Initially, I wanted to do like a racetrack for spaceships, or axle craft or both, but the race initiators won't start up in a spaceship. You can't put markers on the rings that are big enough to read, to follow a course. So I made a little bit of a drift track slash jump over. It also has really cool floating islands, like that last plateau we were just on. What is this thing doing? Kicking me clear over here out of the portal. That was weird. The base isn't all that crazy. It does have some unique aspects to it. I was supposed to have all the exocraft in here, and once I got one in here, I was like, oh, that's big enough. Or that's enough space to hog up. But you could put more exocraft in there. It's supposed to be like the garage area. Oh, what was that? Do you guys see that? Something just hurt me inside my exocraft. But this is the build. It's got a lot of those small floor panels that are in the adornments or whatever, in the base parts, to give it this lit up edge effect. Tons of these little walls stacked on top of each other and then used as roof panels and glitched together. Also used them as the skirt down here to give the edge of the building a nice little glow. It's a combination of interior parts, blocks, and regular, looks like metal parts, all in the same build, on top of a really cool floating island that gets close enough to another floating island over there that I built a little jump over to it, and another little jump back from it. And part of the racetrack goes over there, but this chromatic planet with all these rings is just a really cool feel to it. Kind of eerie, kind of dark. The rings are really cool too. I don't think I can get close enough to any of them, maybe this one. But they have like this blue glow of electricity to them, kind of. I think it's just because of the system. Usually the chromatic systems are just red and black, but this one is red and black and blue. Like the landing pads shine blue, some of the decals and stuff shine blue. You can see a little bit of blue on that ring, but when you get closer, there's like actual veins of blue in the rings. See if I can get a better view of it over here. Oh, sun came out. Now it's all looking purple and stuff. Maybe it's just at night that it looks blue. I'm not really seeing it that well either. The other time, last time I was here, it was like big, bright blue electric lines going through those rings. Anyways, let's run the racetrack. See if we can beat our time. track. You don't get to see your time nowhere. Kind of whack. Okay, start the race. 3, 2, 1 thing, or no, just go. Marker there. Cruise out here onto this little thing. Do a turnaround. Not a very complicated racetrack, but it's still tricky when you're up on top of this little narrow floating island. You fall off, you don't come back up. You definitely don't want your drift tires on this course. You want your sticky tires. Alright, let's see if we can get enough gusto up. Oh, I didn't make it. Such a loser. Well, not gonna beat my time. See? Oh, it's not showing up blue on those either. Kind of a light blue. Green? I don't know. I need a ramp to get me back up there. I did a little bit of a ramp over here, I think, somewhere. Maybe I already tore it out. Originally I wanted to jump through the rings. Where is that ring that I built the ramp on though? This one over here? Nope. I think it was that ring over there, but... Let's go check out my little power farm over here and animal feeders. Kind of got a unique feel to it. There's the teleporter down here. And here's the feeders and milkers. Here's the power hotspot. Real easy, glitched in both directions. Usually this nice circular power supply. Pretty cool looking, I think. Out of the normal, at least. Asymmetrical. Hey, at least when you end the race, it brings you back up here. Try that race again. Race canceled. Start race. Oh, I'm already in my car. Initiating race. Oh. Restart with down. Hold down. Restart race. Oh, sure enough. 2, 1, go. Oh, did I miss it? I missed that first checkpoint. They need to make exocrafts faster, I think. Or just give them more inventory space so you can make them faster and max out the upgrades. Big old phoenixes on this planet too. Pretty cool. Okay, let's give it all she got. Oh, what did I hit? That was, oh no, I'm falling through the void. Really? Okay. Well, shoot. Let's just get our buggy back out and see if we can even make it over that jump. I know I've made it before. I don't know what I hit going off of the jump though. Something kicked me sideways. Checkpoint, and then you turn around and you come back and you hit the jump again. Give it everything she's got, hit the X button. Oh, I didn't make it. Oh, I did make it. Gotta give it everything she's got. And that's the finish line. Usually takes you like a minute and a half, 2 minutes if you make it over the jump. And that's my racetrack build on this really cool planet. I want to thank everybody that's here. Which is myself, only one watching. Hope this inspires somebody out there to go build a track or find a cool planet. Into the main part of the build. You can do bleachers and stuff up here. Instead, I just did a railing where people can hang out and watch the race. 360 degrees. And then the upstairs is just a room that's not decorated. A big open ceiling. Center support. Experimental, using interior parts and regular parts and blocks. Fun place to come visit and hang out and fly around. Said originally I wanted it to be like a spaceship course that we could get 3 or 4 people to race through. Have a starting line and finish line and marked rings or something. Come down to this ring and flip a B and come back. Then whether or not you hit a ring or not, it's just kind of on the merit system. Kinda couldn't think of a good word to use. Make it a little bit tricky, especially if you flew like underneath this little bridge or something. Nope. It's a weird place, the anomaly threw me one night. And do it for me tonight, guys. See you on the flip side.